in the middle of a sweltering summer, when people couldn't liven, experience enjoyment, happiness, passion, it suddenly started snowing. This was hot snow. Winter returned overnight, or perhaps it was more that summer disappeared in the blink of an eye. And since autumn had not yet arrived, winter instead came hurrying back. During that year's sweltering summer, time fell out of joint. It became insane, even downright mad. Overnight, everything degenerated into disorder and lawlessness. And then it began to snow. Indeed, time itself fell ill. It went mad. The wheat had already ripened, but the succulent wheat fragrance that had blanketed the land was dulled by this snowstorm. When the people of Lyven had gone to sleep that evening, they hadn't bothered to pull up their sheets and had lain naked in bed, idly cooling themselves with fans made from paper and cattail leaves. After midnight, however, a fierce wind began blowing, and everyone frantically reached for their covers. Even wrapped in their sheets, the villagers felt as though the bitterly cold air was cutting straight to their bones and immediately started rummaging for their winter quilts. When the villagers opened their front door the next morning, the women exclaimed, "Oh, it's snowing! It's hot summer snow!" The men paused and sighed. "Damn, it's a hot blizzard. It's going to be another famine year." The children cried out brightly as though it were New Year's Day, "It's snowing! It's snowing!" The elms, poplars, mangroves, and pagoda trees were all blindingly white. In winter, it's merely the trees' trunks and branches that get covered in snow. But in summer, their canopies are transformed into enormous white umbrellas. When the leaves are no longer able to support the weight of the snow, it cascades to the ground. This hot snow came just after the wheat had ripened, and many sites throughout the Balu Mountains were transformed into winter wonderlands. In one field after another, the wheat stalks were pinned cruelly to the ground by the snow. And while an occasional ear of wheat might be visible, the vast majority of the stalks were splayed out as though they had been blown over by a tempest. If you were to stand on the ridge above the fields, however, you would still be able to smell the scent of the wheat, like incense that lingers long after a coffin has been carted away. Look, the hot snow that fell in the middle of this sweltering summer transformed the entire land into a winter wonderland, leaving everything pristinely white. Needless to say, for the village of Lyven, nestled in a valley deep in the Balu Mountains, this snowfall in the fifth month of the Wu Yin year of the Tiger, 1998, constituted a veritable natural disaster.
炎热热的酷夏日人本就不受火，却又落了一场雪，死成大热雪。一夜间，冬天又折身回来了。也许是转眼里夏天走去了，秋天为期来，冬天紧绷赶到了。这年的酷夏里，思绪乱了肛肠了，神经错乱了，有了羊角风，在一天的夜里飘飘落落的乱了肛肠了，没有王法了，下了大雪了。 真是的，时光有病了，神经错乱了。小麦已经满熟呢，一时间满意的热香却被大雪覆盖了。售货庄里的人虽脚是赤裸裸的在床上摇着大破扇，软子扇，身边放了一张布单，也是不盖的。可是到了下半夜，先是刮了一阵风，随都迷失眼了，扯着了单子了，把单子搭在身上了，却又浇的是寒气。 从单子的缝中往人的深骨里钻，往心肝里、脾胃里钻，就气喘吁吁地跪里翻的收拾好的被子了。来日里，各家推开屋门了，女人妒忌色地惊叫：“呀，下雪了！五黄六月大热雪！”男人们一色地推开屋门，待一会儿叹一口气说：“操，大热雪又要黄年了！”孩娃们一色地有光有彩地喊：“啊，下雪了！啊，下雪了！像日子又过到了新年了。” 庄里的榆树、槐树、桐树、杨树们，是实实在在的白了呢。冬天落雪，那树是一枝一枝的白；夏天落雪，一盆黄绿，一片绿荫。 这就白的冷不丁了白成一堆了，白成三分了，像撑着一堆一把硕大的厚重的白伞了，轻不动雪的树叶让雪从叶上滑下来，蓬一下，如一团面粉落下来，在地上炸出许多白亮亮的点。没收时间落了大热雪，八路山脉间的许多地处了，都皑皑白出一缕冷势了。原先一块连着一块的麦田地，小麦卧伏了。
蚕丛里伏在大被大雪覆盖着，又碎了，蹭到雪外的，也大都从碎根那儿遮住脖，零零乱乱，像大风吹过的谷底和草坡，又被大雪覆盖去了。你站在山脉上，站在田头上，还闻到一丝麦香味，就像抬走棺材后灵棚的一丝香火味。你看哟，苦下里落一场大热雪，茫茫白白一片里，结结瘦瘦一世界，不消说。 农历守龙的庚辰年，癸卯六月，八路山脉的这场雪，让整个山脉和山脉间的售货庄都遭了天灾了。